and the musical performance differences in a way to make one unified and harmonious performance in the spirit of the Daniel Pearl Music Foundation's mission, which is mutual understanding and respect in a multicultural environment. I'm very pleased that we have a few guests who will welcome you first before the musicians start. And we'll start off with our chargé d'affaires at the U.S. Embassy, Mr. Thomas Hoekner.
Thank you. Deputy Chief of Mission, Thomas Goldberger, this is your Steve Lindeker, Counselor for Press and Cultural Affairs, dear Pearl family, dear audience, Shalom Tov Lekulam. Music is also called the language of the world, the language used by souls when they communicate with one another. A language that does not need to be translated because it appears directly to a person's spirit. So there is nothing more natural than to turn to music when we want to create an international, a manifesto that across borders is shared by all mankind. Its purpose is to bring nations, cultures, and religions closer together, so to condemn hatred and to keep alive the memory of those who were innocent victims of hate targeted against people who are simply different. Daniel Pearl was not murdered in Pakistan by his abductors because of something he did. He was murdered because of who he was. He was a journalist, he was an American, and he was a Jew. And according to his captors, blinded by hate, each of these three parts of his identity was enough to make him someone who deserved to die. You shall not hate is not one of the Ten Commandments, but you shall not murder is a human law that all religions obey. It is too bad that the extremism of some Muslim groups make them forget this fundamental moral obligation which view life as holy. Tonight we want to re-emphasize that this is not the way to resolve conflicts between human beings. But we have also come here to make it clear that we will not stand by and do nothing against those who do not obey the commandment of you shall not murder. Together, Americans and Israelis will fight them every step of the way. We are glad that we have been the opportunity here this evening to demonstrate that we are in complete agreement, at least once. And at the same time express our sincere identification with the family's pain and sadness, Daniel's family. May you know no more sorrow. Thank you.
Amen. a year for rich history. We would have loved to be with you in person tonight, but circumstances dictate that we send you this blessing from a distance, although we are with you in spirit. They traveled the world with a pen and a field, connecting people through words and music. Tonight, he is watching your faith and under light it with a smile and wonder at the global symphony that his journey has inspired. His figure was not silent. By dedicating your concert to his memory, you elevate your music from the acoustic of one concert hall into the balcony of the 21st century and transform it into a statement of purpose, unity and empowerment. Pablo Casals once said, music must serve a purpose. It must be part of something larger than itself, a part of humanity. Your music will serve a purpose, for it will blend with the sound of hundreds, perhaps thousands of concerts around the world this month, ringing the earth for sanity and humanity. Your music today resonates in defiance of the forces of hatred that took our son's life, and we reinforce our unshakable conviction that at the end of the day, music will triumph and humanity will prevail. Our deepest appreciation goes to the organizer and the musician who helped put this evening together. And in particular to Mr. Bill Shohar and to Mr. Leonard Pashka for supporting the Daniel Pearl World Music Day. United, we are making a difference. Thank you.
First movement of the famous Beethoven Moonlight Sonata to Daniel Pearl.